أعوذ بالله من الشيطان اللعين الرجيم بفضل بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم لا حول ولا قوة إلا بالله العلي العظيم الحمد لله رب العالمين والصلاة والسلام على أشرف الأنبياء والمرسلين محمد وآله الطيبين الطاهرين. Once again, مؤمنين المؤمنات, we continue to look at ways and means that I and you can prepare ourselves properly in welcoming the holy month of Ramadan. In this episode, I would like to pay special attention, not general attention like before, to the teachings from the sermon of our beloved prophets on the last Friday of the holy month of Sha'ban. During the previous episode, we looked at the general overview of that beautiful sermon. You see, the holy prophet presented us with a holistic program that I and you need to undertake during the holy month of Ramadan to ensure that our fast is accepted by Almighty Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The Holy Prophet began that sermon by saying, Ayyuhan nasu, O people, innahu kad aqbala ilaykum shahrullahi bil barakati wal rahmati wal maghfira. Indeed, the month of Almighty Allah is coming towards you, is approaching. But this month is approaching with blessings, mercy, and forgiveness. But what is interesting is that the Holy Prophet gave us examples of the mercy, the forgiveness, and the blessings in this holy month of Ramadan. And it is important I and you get inspired by these blessings and mercies and forgiveness. So let's look at a few examples in this episode. The Holy Prophet outlined them, and I quote. The first one, he said, "Nawmukum fihi ibadah." Your sleep or sleeping during the holy month of Ramadan, it is an act of worship. Habibi, my dear brother and sister, if a sleep is an act of worship in the holy month of Ramadan, then it is logical for one to prepare him or herself for these months in which one's sleep is regarded as a worship of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Then Prophet mentioned, "Amalukum fihi makbul." Your deeds, your actions in the holy month of Ramadan are accepted by Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala. You will only find something like this in the holy month of Ramadan and not in any other month. Du'a'ukum fihi mustajab. Your supplications are accepted, are taken to Allah in the holy month, my dear brothers and sisters. So why not prepare ourselves so that we are able to swim in the oceans of Allah's blessings, mercies, and forgiveness in the holy month of Ramadan. And last but not least, you know, the Holy Prophet, interestingly, continued in this beautiful sermon to indicate to us those blessings and those mercies. Said, "Ayyamuhu afdalul ayyam." Days of the holy month of Ramadan are the best days. These are days that cannot be compared with any other day during the year. Hence, the need to prepare ourselves. Layalihi afdalul layali. Allahu Akbar. The nights of the holy month of Ramadan are the best nights. They are nights that I and you cannot afford to waste. They are days that I and you cannot afford to waste. And last but not least, sa'atuhu afdalu sa'at. Each and every hour of the holy month of Ramadan is the best. Prophet said, hours within this month are the best hours in comparison to any other hour in the course of the day. So, mu'minin and mu'minat, let's prepare ourselves spiritually, socially, and physically in welcoming the holy month of Ramadan. Aqulu qawli hadha wa astaghfirullah li wa lakum. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.